Hey, how you doing? I'm Toxic Brenner, and welcome to my regular series in which I look at the first 30 minutes of a game, be it new or old. The reason for only 30 minutes of gameplay is that's enough time to know if a game's something you're interested in picking up and playing yourself without having the game spoiled. Today, we're going to be getting hands-on with a first-person horror called Silver Chains, which was released yesterday. The premise for the game is we play as somebody called Peter, who finds himself in a mysterious house after a car accident, and whilst looking for help, we quickly become aware that a broken car isn't going to be our only problem, as something evil is hiding in the shadows. Currently, this is available to play on PC, but don't worry if you're on console, as the developers Cracked Heads Games have confirmed the PlayStation 4, Xbox One, and Nintendo Switch versions will be available in Q1 next year, so that's sometime between January and April. Be sure to keep a lookout for the free PC game hidden in plain sight, because there's one in every episode of the first 30 minutes. And with that being said, your 30 minutes of gameplay starts now. Okay. This is the car accident then.
God! Crashed into a tree.
That you did. So what is this set? It's gonna looks 1920s, but all right, let's go.
Where am I?
That is a very good question.
I'm so close. Maybe there's someone who can help me.
Okay. So is I delivering something here? Definitely coming here. Now this has been made in the Unreal Engine, so it's going to be a good looking game. Alright, what's happening here? Oh, there's someone up at the window. Okay. Personally, I'll be walking the other way about now. Yeah, no lights. Let's go. Right, it's getting dark. Okay. I can't move. So is this a dream? Okay, how did I get here? The last thing I remember is an accident in this house, but I passed out in the backyard. How did I not read all the text before it disappeared? I'll never know. So who put me in the bed? I'm dressed. Good. It's always a good thing. Speaker room. Game looks good. I'll give it that, but it is made in the Unreal Engine, so I didn't think it wouldn't be. What's that here? We go in here? Can't see anything. No. I mean, no. This is not the house you want to wake up in. Can I open the door? Yeah. Nice looking bathroom. That's nice. That's disgusting. Alright. Mental note to self, use the floor as a toilet. Oh, what's this? The key in the library. What could be there? What's in here? Guess the key for that box is in the library. Press tab to open inventory. Okay, press spacebar to magnify. Oh, like spacebar to turn that into text. That's good. October 31st, 1900, I'm left completely alone. All of the maids resigned out of fear for their lives. I can't blame him. I would run away too. Yeah, so would I, if I could, but what's done is done. I cannot hide. I cannot sleep. I hear them laughing and talking all the time. And this demonic giggling is driving me crazy. I know there is only one way to get rid of all this. This is my last entry. Goodbye. All right. Middle mouse button is magnify. So, okay. We can rotate this, but how do I shut this? Ah,
Jesus Christ.
Fine.
What happened here?
Good question. Can we open this door? No. Open that one, yeah.
It's so dark in here.
Right, it's not letting me go any further. Alright, I got you. You want me to find a torch? Okay, thanks for watching. This is me now. Bye. I have to say, if you've watched my walkthrough of the Dark Occult that was initially called The Conjuring House, this looks very familiar. So, same assets have been used. But there's nothing wrong with that. It's a good looking game. Oh. Okay. Completely meant to do that. Press thumb mouse button to pull out remove lamp. Right. Now I have rebound the keys. I made them a little bit more user friendly. And the good thing is it does pick up the two thumb buttons on the mouse without any issue. Can't open this. Can't open that. Right. Although I can crouch, I have to press E to go through. Okay. Oh, he made me go prone. All right, I got you. You're forgiven. So, which way? Right. Won't let me go that way. Guess we go that way. The house is abandoned, but the lights are on. Maybe someone is here. Well, I'm guessing because we woke up in a bed, somebody put us there. Right, we're going to ignore that for now. Let's just try some doors. I hate things that are covered in sheets in these kind of games. I just don't trust them. I mean, that's normal, right?
What was that?
I'm pretty sure I saw a ghost here. I need to get out of here. The way out is on the first floor. How do I know this? I've just arrived. Mind you, I guess it makes sense. Nothing in here. Right. Oh, have I got a weapon? Oh, there's a bloody handprint there. Ah, I have got stuff. So we've got a locket with the photos inside. There's me and some woman whose face I cannot recognize. Okay. More reading. Right, so this is September the 5th, and that's a little bit before the previous note. So my mates heard me screaming and called Dr. Morgan after the incident, without my knowledge. Not happy about that. Maybe they did the right thing, but I'm sure I heard that terrifying voice. I tried to explain it to the doctor, but he was convinced that it was a side effect of my medication. He said it may have caused hallucinations because I misused it. All right, he thought you were tripping balls. I got you. So I was prescribed a new medication, and Dr. Morgan asked our new nanny to make sure that I took it correctly, and maybe it was a hallucination after all. All right, Dr. Morgan thinks you're taking too many meds.
It seems the person who wrote this diary was troubled with hallucinations.
How are we going to believe it was a hallucination? We've just seen a ghost. Not a problem. Let's keep moving. All right. Wants me to look at this. Let's play. No. No, 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 no. No, no, no. No, 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 no. No, thank you. You're fine. Absolutely fine. Not interested. Alright, come on then. Let's have a look. Alright, no. Door's locked. It's fine. Oh, can I use the poker? Alright, now I can rotate it, but I can't use it. Alright, is there a key in here? Stop that. Alright. okay. You know something's coming out of the water. Still think it's an hallucination? Rotate. Okay, so we've unfolded it. Ah, it's text. Important, don't forget to lock the back stairs door and leave the key in the utility room. P.S. Children are not allowed to play in the kitchen. Not since the incident. Let me out. Now, these games rely on the fact that the protagonist is stupid enough not just to smash a window and climb out. Oh, we've got another note. Come in. Okay, thank you. Ah, you're going to be in here, aren't you? No. What did that achieve? Oh! I see! Move your mouse. Oh, I got you. Okay. So I've got to keep it in the circle. Oh, I see. All right, I'm there now. Got it. So now we have the key for the lock. Perfect. So I'm guessing this is upstairs where we came in. No. I'll open that door. Anything in here? Anything in there? No. Just run. Keep on running. Keep on running this way. It's fine. It's going to be fine. It's not a problem. Always got to check behind doors. My beloved Harold died yesterday, August the 21st.
Looks like this woman started to have problems after her husband's death.
I think she might have had problems before, to be quite honest with you. Sinister music. It's coming. Right, so we can go out that way. Somebody lit the fire. Ah, here we go. More doors that are opening. Anything up here? No. Why are their rooms boarded up?
Peter, is that you?
No, not Peter. No. Oh, it is Peter. Yeah, I am Peter.
She's looking for you. Mummy is very mad at you.
Okay. I met someone in the dining room. It was a little girl, or at least looked like her. Somehow knows my... Right. The text that disappears too quickly. I mean, that's easy enough to fix for the devs. And you have to remember, they are Russian. So English isn't going to be their first language, so maybe they've got the timings down for Russian rather than English. A camera. What was that? Oh, more reading. Dear diary, the day before yesterday, my Harold came back after a long journey. I missed him so much and our children couldn't be happier. Finally, the whole family was back together. Yesterday, we spent all day together and he told us stories of his adventures. He brought us so many presents. Our children were very excited about all the toys and dolls that he brought. Harold is feeling unwell after a long ride home. I think he's just tired. I'll go draw him a nice hot bath. August the 17th. No, Harold isn't going to be very well.
They were happy for such a short time.
All right. Somewhere in a different world, you feel a door opening. Ah, that's a Resident Evil Easter egg. Nice, like it. If you haven't played Resident Evil, the very first one, I believe it's the first one. There's definitely... What was that, please? Thank you. Do you mind? There's a puzzle that you solve. Plays that music and the door opens. That's nice. I like that. So don't need the torch here. Might need a different key. Wasn't the skeleton key that we got? Oh no. Thank you. Thank you, little girl. Okay. A tall, terrifying woman chased me. No doubt she wanted to kill me. Apparently it was the mother of the little girl warned me about. I have to... Please allow me to finish the text. All right. So that's where we came in. And did we walk through there? I'm not too sure. So the delay for text is definitely an issue, but that's an easy fix by the devs. They can change that.
I remember this lamp. It contains a secret. I think it works as a lever.
Okay. WS to move the handle. Alright, so I've got to put the pattern on the wall. No? Let's try spinning it the other way. No? All right, we come back to that. No more. The answer to the puzzle is going to be in here, and I'm guessing that's where key's going to be. But how do we know we got the right direction? Any clues? Or is it just hit and miss? What am I missing? Right, is there something in one of the other rooms? No, not in the blocks. Right, let's go and look back downstairs. Oh no, we can look further along here. Maybe the clue's in here? No, we just have wardrobes. And we have that. Sounds like there's something behind the closet. Sneaky. Okay. In here. Ah, she saw me. She so saw me. No. No, she didn't see me. Fine. The answer to our puzzle has to be in here. Souls of the Dead will never fulfill your request just like that. They like to make riddles and come to you only after you solve their riddles or fulfill their requests. Usually these puzzles are connected with their lives somehow. In order to solve them, I had to rummage through their past and learn all sorts of details of their lives. Thanks to the diaries, it was not difficult. But with children, it's not so simple. Basically, they want to play, but games are unusual. Sometimes the dead build barriers in the present through which a human can't pass. They open them only if you fulfill their conditions. But we must remember that they see the world quite differently. Yeah. A blackboard and a teared to pieces photo. It seems like someone wants me to find all the pieces. Okay. Find, okay. More reading. September the 14th. Dear diary, I don't understand what is happening in this house. I don't trust anyone. Last night I woke up and went to check on the kids. When I entered the room, I noticed the smell. The same smell that always accompanied Harold when he returned from a hunt. I looked under the bed and found the decapitated remains of animals. There was so much blood and it was mixed with dirt and bits of fur. And that stench! And it was all under the beds of my children. I took the kids to my room and ordered the servants to clean the mess. Who would have done something like that? Seems to me that someone is trying to drive me crazy on purpose to take away the only thing I have left. My children.
Dead animals in the children's room? That's terrible.
Yeah. It is terrible. So there we go. This is Silver Chains. It's not a bad game, actually. It is using a lot of assets from the Unreal Engine, which I don't mind. I think they're being used really well. The game is really well optimized, which is good because I've played other games. I mean, if you have a look at The Conjuring House, or sorry, The Dark Occult, as it's now known, this used the same assets and it wasn't very well optimized when it was launched. I would say it does need the timings extended on the text just by a couple of seconds, but you know, they are an indie team and they are also Russian, so they may not know the timings for the English language, and it's easy enough to fix. They've only got to be extended by a couple of seconds, as I say. Also, at some points when I'm looking at the doors, the E to interact with the door, or the object doesn't appear straight away. But overall, I think it's a solid game. I think it'll be fun to play. It'll definitely be fun to stream. But let me know what you think. Is it something you play? I'm always interested to know. And until next time, take it easy.